Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showing you how to play 8 iconic pop punk riffs. Technically there's 9 because there's going to be a little extra secret one at the end, which some people don't consider pop punk, but I kind of do. It's going to be a lot of fun, this video. These are the kind of riffs where, even if you just play, I'm not going to teach you the whole song, just the riffs. If you play them at sound check or at school with your friends or at a band practice or something, you'll turn heads, both young and old. Established guitar players and beginner guitar players will all turn and go, I know that song, that's a banger. Obviously there's way more than just 8/9 iconic pop punk riffs from back in the day and now to this day. I'd be here all day if I showed you how to play all of them. So comment down below your favorite pop punk riff, whether it's in this video, whether it's not in this video. And yeah, let people know how easy or difficult it is to play, or do a video yourself showing you how to play them. So without further ado, let's get into it. Here's the first riff. It's iconic, and I hope you'll know it. If you don't, then you definitely should. Now I'm just going to teach you the first little intro bit, but the rest of the song is so much fun to play. There's plenty of places online to teach you how to play the rest of the song, but here's how you play that iconic intro of Fat Lip by Sum 41. So Fat Lip is in drop D, so standard tuning with the bottom low E string dropped to a D. An octave of a D. Starts on the 6th fret of the low E string, which is now a D. 6, 7, 9. Palm mute them as well. Then move your first finger down to the 6th fret of the D string. Don't palm mute that, but let that ring out. Play it again. But instead of going to the 6th fret of the D, go to the 9th fret of the A. And the last time round, on the 9th fret of the A, slide down to the 7th fret. And that's how you play a Fat Lip. Let's stick in drop D for the next riff, which again is an absolute banger. All the songs in this list are absolute bangers. Everyone should know them, and everyone knows the lyrics and the riff. And this is the next one. It's iconic. It is, of course, Girl All the Bad Guys Want by Bowling for Soup, and here's how you play it. So again, staying in drop D. First note is a D, so the low E string does open. Then the next little line, 5th fret of the A string, 4th fret, and then the open A string. Then the 4th fret on the low string, E, which is now a D. Then repeat that run on the A string as well, to 5-4 open. Then repeat that one more time, but this time start with the 5th fret of the low string. So we've got. The last little line. Second fret on the A string. Open. 5-4-0 on the low E string, which is now a D. Together, slowly. Ramping up the game. So much fun to play. So much fun to play. Now next up, I just had to show you a Blink song. Blink, or iconic Blink 182. I've realized all the songs I'm teaching you are with an overdriven tone. This one is the only one which is somewhat clean. I was gonna show you like Damn It and stuff. But let's clean up a little bit for the next song. But say clean, you've gotta have a dirty guitar tone. Just roll the volume down and clean it up a little bit. Maybe like that, and it's this. of course, What's My Age Again, which is a great grid. Great riff to play anyways, but when you play that on a clean sound, even play it on an acoustic guitar or something, and you're in a guitar shop, everyone will go, oh, it's Blink! He's playing Blink! And here's how you play it. This song's in standard tuning, but without the drop D, so it's just regular tuning now. And it's really focused around the 9th fret. Put your first finger on the 9th fret, or you might be able to change this once I explain how it works, the 9th fret of the D string, and your ring finger on the 11th fret of the G and the B. Power, like a little power chord like that, you know how you get those kind of power chords, that. But up here, again, turn that volume down to make it cleaner. And just pick like that. Then you can either move your first finger down to the string below, which is the A string, or you can start this riff by having your entire first finger on the ninth fret over all the strings, because we're actually going to be descending down the strings, playing the 9th fret while accenting the 11th of the G and the B, so they don't actually change, but... So we'll play the same note, the same kind of note, if that makes sense, but we'll go down a string on the 9th fret to start on the D string. Now it gets complicated. The last note you play in that little phrase bit is the 11th fret of the low E string. It's quite a hard riff to play, especially up to speed, because you do have a habit of catching the strings in between, especially when you're going from the low string to hit the 11th fret of the G and the B. And not letting notes ring out when they shouldn't, but yeah, in essence, that is... Those are the notes of the riff. Now it's down to you to keep practicing it to get it nailed. And that's What's My Age Again. Next up, we have a song which is, again, a bit difficult to play in a different way to what Blink is. It's just a bit, if you're a beginner, there's some interesting stretches. I had to include some Offspring, but I didn't want to do the obvious one. I wanted to do this because it's just epic. It is, of course, The Kids Aren't Alright, and here's how to play it. Again, it's in standard tuning. First little shape is the 8th fret on the D string and the 6th fret on the G string. You're gonna get some palm mutant rhythm on the go. But accenting every now and then along with the track, like it does on the track. So we're gonna accent twice with the fingers, with your fingers where I've just said they are. And the third time, move your first finger down to the 5th fret. So you stay on the 8th fret of the D, but you move down a fret to the 5th fret of the G for the third time. And then back up to the 6th. Bit hard to play, up to speed if you're just a beginner. You can mess around with finger placement as well. Again, what I'm teaching you right now is just the way I've been doing it. If you find it more comfortable playing it a different way, totally do it that way. So that's the first little chord, let's say, in the riff. Remember that picking pattern as well, where you accent the notes. You're gonna repeat that same kind of picking pattern in the next chord, which is where you kind of swap over fingers. We're gonna do like traditional kind of power chord shape down here. So the 4th fret of the D string and the 6th fret of the G string. So we're going from 2. So the same kind of picking pattern, and we're going from the 6th fret on the G, down to the 5th fret, then back to the 6th fret, keeping that original 4th fret of the D string. Now we're going to play the same fret, the 6th fret of the D and the G. with the accent note going down the 5th fret. All together so far. Now for the last little accent bit. So we're keeping that 6th fret on the D string. On the G we're going 8, 6, 5, 6. You got to mess with your finger placement quite a bit. Yeah, if you find an easier way to do it than what I'm doing, feel free to do that. This isn't gospel, but... And the main riff when it comes in, it goes down to the 1st fret of the A string. So that's 1, 3, 4 on the A. 2nd fret on the low E string. 3, 4 again. There we go, 4, 6 on the low string. Four, six, three, and then on the A string. Three, four, six, four, three. You know. And that's The Kids Aren't Alright by The Offspring. Next up, I'm gonna start using a looper because by itself, some of these common riffs might sound a bit naff, so you need a looper to play the backing track. There's two main kind of riffs in pop punk, single note riffs or octave riffs, and sometimes they need a bit of backing to give you the full force. So this is My Friends Over You by Newfound Glory. So that was out a bit naff by itself. So here's how you play both parts. So this is in standard again, the rhythm is just a straight up D power chord. With that kind of rhythm, so that's a 5th fret on the A string and a 7th fret on the D string. Then down to a G power chord. So that's a 3rd fret of the low E and the 5th fret of the A. And the main riff, 5th fret, and the 7th fret of the B string, 5th fret, and the 7th fret of the G string. Every now and then go to the 7th fret of the B. I've seen a few different ways in how it ends. I've seen people use that. Power chord on the 5th fret and the 7th fret. From the G, or just the 7th fret of the G and the B. And that's how to play an epic Newfound Glory riff. Next up we have a song which I totally didn't forget to put in when I recorded yesterday and then realised last night that it's one of the most iconic riffs of all time. No, this isn't that at all. I promise. It's this. It is, of course, my own worst enemy by Lit, and here's how you play it. I think I'm getting away with this, just nice. It's super easy to play, it's in standard tuning. And it starts off with a lovely octave line. So that is the 6th fret of the A string and the 8th fret of the G string. And go chromatically 1 fret to the 7th fret and the 9th fret of the A and the G. Then you move down a string to play power chords. So that's a B and an A, so that is the 7th fret and the 9th fret of the lower E and the A string. Move down 2 frets to the A, so the 5th fret and the 7th fret. Or I can go B A here. If you like, and after that, it's a big old E. Super easy riff, one of the most iconic pop punk riffs of all time. And I can't believe I forgot it. No one's gonna know. They're gonna know. Next up, as of recording this video, they've just released some new music. This is, of course, Paramore, and one of their most famous songs, and you can play it in a couple of different parts of the fingerboard. This is where I like to play it. It's Misery Business. So this song is an E flat with the bottom string dropped to drop D. So it's regular drop D, but a half step down. We're not actually going to use the low E string for this riff, but if you want to play the entire song, it's in drop D, but half a step down, so drop C sharp. So the way I like to play it is starting on the 12th fret of the A string. 12th fret of the A, then the 9th and the 11th fret of the D string. Then the 11th fret of the A, so moving down a fret. Then repeat it, go back up to the 12th fret, and then end the last little phrase bit on the 7th fret of the A string. So in all you get. Then it ends with a little run. To 7-9 on the A string. 7-9 again on the D string. Slide up to 11. Then 9-11 on the G string. So that's one way of playing it, but instead of using the 12th and the 11th on the A string, you can stay on that D string and play it with the 7th fret and the 7th fret and the 6th fret, as opposed to the 12th fret and the 11th fret of the A. So it'll be something like. Now this is technically the last pop punk song before we get into our special little bonus one at the end, and it's one of my favourite ever songs growing up. It's so easy, and it absolutely blows everyone's minds. It's great, so much fun. Of course, Skater Boys, but with an id by Avril Lavigne. Here's how you play it. So this is in standard tuning again. I was using a looper there to get to play the rhythm bits. So the rhythm bits, D power chords, so the 5th fret and the 7th fret of the A and the G. A power chords, so again the same fret, just on the low E and the A string. Move up 2 frets to the 7 and the 9. Then descend chromatically to the 6 and the 8, and landing on the 5 and the 7 of that, the E and the A. So that's the backing, and the main riff is simply. So those are octaves, so you're missing out the middle string. 7th fret and the 9th fret of the A and the G. Slide it up to the 11 and the 9. Keep the same strings and everything in the same shape, just move it up 2 frets. 2 frets and end the phrase, end the light lead line I should say. Sliding down to the 5th fret and the 7th fret of the A and the G. What an absolute belter of a tune. Now last up, one of my favourite bands of all time, My Chemical Romance. I know they're not pop punk, they're emo, even though they've been called emo. If you make the lyrics happy, it's just pop punk music. All my pop punk friends are like, emo music isn't, but it's the same kind of. Bit more rocky, but it's the same kind of octave-y, fun pop punk lyric. Pop punk songs, but the lyrics are a little bit sadder. The first CD I ever bought with my own money was Welcome to the Black Parade. This isn't off that, this is this, and it's a joy to play. ¶¶ PMTVUK off Three Cheers for Sweet Revenge. It's mint, and here's how you play it. So it's in standard again. I was using the looper for the rhythm because by itself the chords are a bit lackluster, so the chords are underneath. Got a D, so a power chord on the 5th fret and the 7th fret of the A and the D string. Same strings down to the 4th, the 2nd fret and the 4th fret. And a big E. And then A. Now you've got to get pretty high up the fretboard for the lead octave bit. Octaves are 17th fret of the A string and the 19th fret of the G string. You don't stray from these strings. You keep the same chord shape on the same strings, you just kind of move them up and down the neck. So 17-19. Down to the 12th fret and the 14th fret. Same strings again. To 10 and 12. And 9-11. Do that twice. Then it goes up the way. So that. 10 and 12 again. Up to 12 and 14. Down to the 9th fret and the... No, the 7th fret and the 9th fret. Then it goes up towards the end of it. Back to 9 and 12. 12 and 14. That is, what's that, 14 and 16. So that last bit there. Just like playing the last octave, go back down and go. Oh my god, it's such a fun riff to play. And when you put it all together, it is a pop punk song. It's totally a pop punk song. And that, ladies and gentlemen, are the 9 iconic riffs I've taught you for this video, because pop punk's having a bit of a resurgence, and I'm definitely here for it. My couple of ones are back as well. I saw them live and they were bloody fantastic. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you want to expand on anything or add anything to this video, please feel free to comment down below and share the love, okay? And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any of the gear I've been playing in this video, everything is linked in the description box down below. It'll take you to PMTOnline.co.uk where you can check it out. We all play music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.